In July 2021, Russian MOD stated that the nation had successfully test-fired its new S-500 air defense missile systems at a southern training range and hit a high-speed ballistic target. The MOD also released the first public footage of the live fire carried out in Kapustin Yar. While the system has seen considerable delay, it now seems to be close to initial deployment. Arguably, there's a lot of interest in S-500, and some commentary on it suggests that it's an invincible system. But there's a lot that needs to be dissected to look beyond the hype. In this video, Defense Updates lists 8 facts about the Russian S-500 Prometey. Let's get into the details. This video is sponsored by the free-to-play online military-themed strategy game, Conflict of Nations, which is played by millions of players worldwide. We talk a lot about military power and tactical plans of different nations on this channel, but what about trying them out for yourself? Conflict of Nations is set in the late 20th and early 21st century, fielding present-day and highly modern battlefield technology. At the core of the game is an exciting real-time combat system, placing players in control of an existing nation of this world and its army, pitting them against other gamers in a struggle for world domination. Units are moved across the map in real time, often taking hours to fulfill their assigned mission goals, allowing for a very deep level of strategic planning and integrated tactical execution. Forming lasting alliances or short-lived coalitions is an essential part of the modern military environment. Hence, Conflict of Nations allows players to form cooperative plans and teams in an all-out effort to conquer set objectives through the combined force of arms. Conflict of Nations can be played in PC or mobile. So why wait? Register yourself using the link in the description below and get 13,000 gold reward along with 1 month Security Council membership. S-500 Prometey is the latest in Russia's S-series air defense system. It's developed by the Russian state-owned company Almaz-Anti. While much of S-500 specs remain classified at this time, the publicly available information suggests that it will be capable of intercepting and attacking a wide variety of targets, including drones, conventional and stealth aircraft, hypersonic weapons, ballistic missiles, including ICBMs, as well as have the ability to take down satellites. Importantly, it's stated to be not an evolutionary, but a revolutionary upgrade when compared to previous systems. The missiles are likely to be carried by and launched from BAZ-69096 trucks with 10x10 configuration. BAZ-69096 is huge when compared to S-400's transporter erector launchers and carries only 2 missiles compared with 4 carried by S-400. This indicates that the missiles will be very large and hence will likely have a much greater range and be able to reach much higher altitudes. While S-400 has an engagement range of 400 kilometers, or 250 miles, S-500 is thought to have expanded it to 600 kilometers, or around 370 miles. The S-500s will work with S-400s, which is expected to completely replace S-300. In an integrated air defense environment, S-500 will hook up with other systems, including S-400, to form a complex network of air defense umbrellas. As per reports, S-500 will primarily focus on anti-ballistic missile role, in which S-400 has limitations. The idea is to use these two systems to create an iron curtain. S-400 uses multiple missiles to cover its strike envelope. The system has 9M96E missile with a short range of 40 kilometers or 25 miles. 9M96E2 missile with a medium range of 120 kilometers or 75 miles, 48 N6 missile with a long range of 250 kilometers or 155 miles, and 40 N6 missile with a very long range of 400 kilometers or 250 miles. S-500 will also be capable of accommodating multiple missiles, but the nature will be different. All S-500 missiles will be long range, but some will be meant for ballistic missile interception, while others will be geared for taking on aircraft, etc. Systems capable of intercepting ICBMs, like American GMD, or ground-based mid-course defense, are not mobile. This is mainly because of the fact that the interceptor missile is very large. But Russia seems to have found a way to make the missiles less bulky when compared to ground-based interceptor of GMD, enabling them to be carried by TEL. All other components are also mobile. Two command posts are planned to be based on BAZ-69092, 12 6x6 trucks. Acquisition and battle management radar is planned to be towed by BAZ-6403.01 8x8 tractor truck. Another acquisition radar is planned to be mounted on the BAZ-69096 10x10 chassis. A multi-mode engagement radar is planned to be mounted on BAZ-6909-022 8x8 truck. The anti-ballistic missile engagement radar is planned to be mounted on BAZ-69096 10x10 chassis. All of these vehicles have good cross-country mobility. This means it will be hard to knock out the S-500 with a preemptive strike. HGVs, or hypersonic boost glide vehicles, are a new crop of weapons. HGV is launched to extremely high altitudes using ballistic missiles, where it skips across the Earth's upper atmosphere. The vehicle then separates from the carrier and glides back to the Earth towards its intended target, attaining hypersonic speed. HGVs combine the speed of ballistic missiles and maneuverability of cruise missiles in a single platform. The current crop of ballistic missile defense systems can calculate the trajectory of incoming missiles since they follow a predefined parabolic path. But with HGV, this tracking methodology will not work and hence are almost impossible to intercept. S-500 is touted as being capable of defeating HGVs too, which makes it the only system of this class. Satellites are one of the most important assets for a nation. They play a vital role in civilian and military communications. Military satellites are used for gathering intelligence, as well as they can monitor and provide early warning against missile launches by a rival nation. Military satellites also provide guidance to missiles, aircraft, and warships, to name a few. So if satellites of a particular nation are destroyed, it will become handicapped in a conflict. This is why the anti-satellite weapon is seen as a key military capability by the world. S-500 is thought to be able to work in anti-satellite role. The radars of an air defense system are like the eyes. As per reports, S-500 has seen a lot of work when it comes to radars. These will be much more powerful compared to what's tagged to S-400. S-500 system is said to be capable of tracking 5 to 20 ballistic targets and intercepting up to 5 to 10 ballistic targets simultaneously. This will enable the system to take on a saturation attack from the enemy. Thanks for watching. Subscribe for more videos like this. Hit the like button if you find the video interesting, and kindly provide your feedback in the comment section. This will help us improve.